no, this is supposed to be a study about Tai Chi Chuan. What is this? This is kickboxing? That's weird. What is the kickboxing doing here? Or we're doing a new movie about kids kung fu again. What is this?
So that's
this is not
really
about kickboxing, and this is also not about
exciting.
Kids. It's actually about the study of Tai Chi Chuan, and then I want to mention this, of course, especially about Taoist Tai Chi Chuan, specifically the forms and the methods that I learned from Wudang and from Qing Shan Shan. I learned with a variety of teachers, and my main teacher is Yao Xuan De, Sifu Yao Xuan De, from Wudang, who also studied in Qing Shan Shan. And I went to Qing Shan Shan especially to study some of the things related to thunder magic and so on, to learn more about it anyway, and to learn the relationship of Wudang Kung Fu with Chun Wu and Tai Yi. Both gods, of course. Chun Wu I studied already, of course, in Wudang itself, and Tai Yi in Qing Shan Shan a bit more in depth. Tai Chi Chuan is a very interesting study. I must say that I'm now studying this over 30 years, and it doesn't stop fascinating me. I just feel that I have made a lot of progress, but all progress has always been incremental. And what I explained to you, of course, is a summary of what I learned within the Patreon program and within the Dongfang Dashui program that I'm also running, the Oriental College Studies. Of course, we have a lot more information. In essence, you can say Tai Chi Chuan comes in three different stages. First stage usually is the military stage, where people want to learn how to fight or to become healthy. Both, of course, is a battle, and for both you need to learn all kind of skills. In essence, in the first stage, you learn about the movement of the jin, that is the different powers of the body and how they move from the body, from the left to the right, from the right to the right, from the top to the bottom, from the bottom to the top, and so forth and so forth. Also in that process there is the conquest of fear. Fear is a very impractical emotion, and rage in the same way is a very impractical emotion, because at the moment when you are in a fighting situation, fear and rage usually make you either lose or lose your ethics. This is of course not very good for you. Then their second stage is basically what I usually call the level of understanding. Here you are getting rid of all kind of aversions that you might have. The aversions that you might have can be about people, can be about things, about foods and stuff like this. And you come to understand that these are all things that stop you from achieving things. And aversions usually put limits on how you are experiencing thing and what you can experience and why you want to experience it. So they also put a limit on your ethics, which of course is in a way is very good, but it has to be a rational ethics that have to do with a lot of different kind of things. But that is of course subject of your studies. And when you are learning martial arts, one of the things that you have to learn to deal with is how to avoid getting hurt and how to hurt other people to avoid getting hurt. This is all about violence and aggression and stuff like this, and so it's also about communication. Then at that moment, the third stage is the stage of developing affinity. And I cannot say that often enough, you can't really develop affinity for everything without doing also Ling Shun meditation. And that is something that is separately taught in the Zhong Wu Qi Kung classes that we do once a month. So if you want to sign up for a Patreon account, then of course this is included. These are studies already in the way. So don't worry about that. This is something you can do and everybody can do. It just takes a lot of time. And Tai Chi Chuan study as such also takes a lot of time. And you will start usually with trying to understand our body and gradually come into more details, which also relate very closely to Chinese medicine, Nei Dan, and so forth. In essence, Tai Chi Chuan learning starts with learning a short form, or 13 form. This one shows you the basics of body mechanisms. And it also shows you the basics of the directionality. And it shows you basically also that Tai Chi Chuan is performance of a ritual. And there's another post where we talk extensively about ritual, and that's a very, very important to understand in relationship to health and so on. Then when you go to a larger form, that's an unfoldment of a shorter form. And an unfoldment of a shorter form means basically that movements, the 13 movements, they are extrapolated to all kind of variations. And that is in itself is like an endless process, like describing the corners in a room. And when you start counting corners, you always come up with new corners. And one of the reasons for this is the third level of doing forms, that is doing the Bakwa directional forms. Every posture has eight directions, so every posture also has eight different applications. And then, of course, there's the learning of the movement from the inside out and from the outside in, which is sometimes called fist first or body first. When you talk about from the inside out, you have to understand that the inside has to be hard and the outside has to be soft. The outside is like water and the inside is like a mountain. And the outside, of course, has to be mobile. So that means you have to work on your flexibility, you have to work on your agility, your speed, and your slowness, and so forth and so forth. And we talk about it later on when we talk about the different add-ons that are all essential for Tai Chi Chuan learning. Form learning in itself is nothing very special. Anybody can learn a form, a kata, but it doesn't mean that you have any understanding. And especially when you want to use it for fighting, I don't think a form will ever be enough. And I usually advise against fighting. I'm a pacifist myself. I learned these kind of things as an alternative for going into the army, because the government, the Dutch government, wanted me to go into the army, and I refused that because I don't think anybody should use any violence against other people. Communication is already hard enough when you just talk, and very often waiting and having the patience for a situation to resolve itself, so follow the natural way, is very often the best way to resolve a conflict. And in the background you can see the movies, which are movies made with me and my student from Canada, Lucas, who was visiting for 2 weeks to study Tai Chi Chuan 36. All the recordings are movements revolving around thunder fist and thunder palm and thunder cloud movements, which are part of the Tai Chi Chuan 36 and Tai Chi Chuan 48 and Tai Chi Chuan 64 and 200 something. Besides all these lengthy forms, the principles of all these movements are very important. And to get to the principles in Tai Chi Chuan, it is not enough to learn form, to do push hands, or to even apply them in martial arts. You have to go into the more esoteric parts. And that's also, of course, why I became a monk at Xuan Wu Pai, to learn more about the esoterics of it, which my teacher Liu already told about, and my Shifu Yao Xuan De told me about in several moments separate from other students, and also during our trips together, and in the night when he take me on my way back to for my training